It's a case that took decades to solve, but this past year, investigators unveiled the true identity of a suspected serial killer known as Robert Evans here in New Hampshire. According to the Attorney General's office, DNA testing led them to uncover his real identity, Terry Peter Rasmussen. Investigators say he's the man responsible for killing a woman and three children who were found in metal drums in Bear Brook State Park in Allenstown in 1985 and 2000. They also believe Rasmussen is responsible for the disappearance and death of Denise Bowden from Manchester.
The more precise that testing has become, the better these techniques become, the more useful they become to law enforcement.
The use of DNA databases and genealogy to help identify victims and suspects is proving to be an effective tool in solving crimes.
What's happened over the years is a lot of times law enforcement would have unidentified human remains, would not be able to identify exactly who that person was. And now by using genealogy, there are some cases where law enforcement is actually able to follow family trees and actually identify that person or persons.
New Hampshire Assistant Attorney General Jeff Strelzin says investigators are now taking DNA from crime scenes, submitting it to genealogy testing databases, and are getting back a list of individuals who may be related.
The investigators would go out and speak to that person, and they would say, we have a victim, looks like a victim of a homicide. We believe it's a female between the ages of 18 and 22. And describe things that they know about that and say, is there anyone in your family you think would fit that description? That's the way that the investigators then would tie those pieces together and make a definite identification.
In theory, it's a great idea. It's a very creative use of forensic DNA evidence. It's in the application that things get messy.
Albert Buzz Schur is a UNH law professor. He says authorities should be leery of privacy concerns when utilizing these genealogy websites.
The database is taking this information from these people without informing them they may use it for this purpose. If they said, by the way, you know, by contributing your profile at these X number of genetic locations, you are authorizing us, if the police ask, to provide them with information, your genealogical information, your genetic location information, then that's fine.
But he says some sites are not, so he warns those who are uploading their information to ask questions.
All they say is, oh, and we may use this, the information we gather from your DNA for other purposes. That's all they say. That's not enough.
Something to think about as this technology continues to advance and DNA testing becomes more accessible to consumers. Kristen Carosa, WMUR News 9.